Getting a caffeine shot is a nice way to jumpstart your day, as coffee promotes wakefulness and enhances alertness by giving a rush of dopamine chemicals to our brain. The body somehow pays a certain toll in order to reap the benefits from this coffee. Although there are certain benefits associated with caffeine, however, an overconsumption can surely be harmful to your body. Although there are several benefits of coffee, however, consumption of caffeine is slowly becoming somewhat of an addiction. In this video, you will learn about the benefits of living a caffeine-free life and how you can reduce your caffeine intake. Avoid common pitfalls that lead you back to coffee. This video will be beneficial to those who are either caffeine addicts or looking to make a positive change to their lifestyle. Hello guys, and welcome to Target 100 Years. We will give you your weekly dose of health tips in lifestyle, medicine, exercise and mindfulness. Top of the list on benefits is better anxiety management. Caffeine gives you a burst of energy, but that energy can stimulate our fight or flight response. According to Cambridge.org, caffeine has some neuropsychiatric effects on our brain. Their study suggests that caffeine has a potential to increase anxiety, hostility, and psychotic symptoms. Also, a study by NCBI suggests that caffeine can make things worse for adolescents who are prone to stress and anxiety by increasing their chances of depression. The second advantage is getting better sleep. There are several studies by some well-known organizations suggesting that coffee can alter our sleep cycle, which can lead to sleepless nights and daytime drowsiness. As caffeine clearly increases alertness and wakefulness, due to that, it can cause sleep disruptive effects on the body. Our body follows a sleep-wake cycle or a circadian rhythm. It gets disturbed, especially when you take caffeine 4 to 6 hours before sleep. It can lead to disturbed sleep and daytime sleepiness. So it's better to go into the caffeine detox mode to get more blissful and undisturbed night sleep. Better aging. Caffeine hampers with the collagen formation by reducing the collagen synthesis. It is the key protein that works as connective tissue in our body. It gives strength and elasticity to the skin. As we age, the collagen formation in our body slowly decreases over time. If you are concerned about aging, it's better not to take caffeine, as it can increase the number of wrinkles on your face and make you look more aged than you actually are. These are some benefits that you can get if you decide to live a caffeine-free life. Now let's focus on the part on how you can reduce caffeine and avoid coming back to it is to quit slowly. It is best to start small when quitting caffeine. Start by replacing one caffeinated drink per day and continue this for a week. For example, if you drink 4 to 5 cups of coffee in a day, try to replace one cup with a non-caffeinated drink and slowly replace one cup at a time over a period of 4 weeks. At the end of the month, you will feel good about yourself for resisting the caffeine temptation. The next thing that you should do is to hydrate yourself. Drinking water regularly will help you in managing the urge of drinking caffeine. Whenever you feel inactive and feel like having coffee, just sip a few glasses of water and breathe deeply. This will suppress the desire for having a coffee and also give more oxygen to your organs so they get active. Another important thing that you must do is to find support. Don't start this detox journey alone. Find someone to do it with you. If you cannot find the support you need, then tell a friend or a family member who can help you in cutting out caffeine. Make weekly markers with incentives that can be decided by both of you. That friend or family can help you stay on the path by sending your daily motivation codes, and you can give them daily updates on your progress. Hopefully these tips will help you reduce your daily intake of caffeine and slowly remove it entirely from your life. But there will be instances that you might relapse and switch back to coffee to feel that high again. Don't worry, we have a solution for you. These tips can help you manage your urges and stay on a caffeine-free lifestyle. Number 1. Avoid alcohol consumption. When you are on a caffeine detox journey, your body is adjusting to new changes. If you consume alcohol in these conditions, it will work as a dehydrating agent. And since it is also a depressant, it will simply increase your caffeine cravings for the next day. The next thing is, give yourself time to rest and recover. By resting and recovering, we mean fast for at least once in a week. Set aside a day, possibly Sunday, to give your body plenty of rest. On that day, you can either choose to do a water fast And in case you're feeling hungry, you can eat fruits or raw vegetables.
The next item on the list is to find positive distractions. At certain weak moments, your body signals you to consume caffeine. Try to map out a pattern when your body gives you these signals. In those times, you have to take your mind off from these cravings. You can try playing a video game, do some exercises, call your best friend. There are other distraction techniques that you can try. Just make sure not to give in to this temptation. The next tip is for working professionals. Most working professionals have a habit of drinking coffee to be more productive throughout the day. If you are one of them and decide to go caffeine free, you will experience some withdrawal symptoms. Feeling low energy is one of them. Slouching on a work desk won't do any good for you. Change your posture to sitting up position to be on alert mode. Also take a break once in a while and listen to calm music. The last item on the list is to try caffeine substitutes. Some people drink coffee usually because of its taste and smell. Like its counterpart, there is decaf coffee available in the market that you can try to get the same taste and smell without getting any caffeine inside your body. You can also try some healthy keto smoothies or herbal tea to satisfy your urges. In the end, it's your battle to go through this caffeine detox journey and avoid coming back to it.
If you liked our video, please press the like button and share it with your friends and family. Subscribe to our channel Target 100 Years and stay with us in this journey. Click on the bell icon to never miss an update. Let us know your thoughts in the comment section down below. Also tell us what are the topics you want to see the next. Stay tuned for our next video. Till then, goodbye.